A and B, but I guess as long as there isn't residue of one on the other, it won't risk them kicking, so.
So wow, this is so different than what we used in the past.
Yeah. Suppose it depends how thick you can play on. That doesn't look like a lot.
What is it, 50-50?
Yeah. One to one, or somebody was saying.
Yeah, yeah.
It's kind of greasy.
It's kind of smush.
Smush it till the color's black and there's no stripes.
Oh wow, it's like silly putty.
Straight forward, huh?
Yeah, it's actually not quite
soft.
It says it is designed for museum reproductions and
it's meant
fine
to be
detail
fairly
stuff.
Detailed but gentle.
Yeah, and for future reference for all of us.
You don't say.
So that.
But how do you get it? I understand coating it.
Once the silicone is coated and it's fully cured, what we'll have to do to support it is make a little, make a jacket out of plaster bandage, which we'll have to basically build a little wall. Build the one half, take the wall away, and build the other half. Either coat the edge with tape or Vaseline or whatever, so that both sides don't stick to each other. And then once that's set, you take the two halves apart and you slice along, and wherever it's convenient to cut a slice, build a pry the rubber apart.
Maybe
an inch of thickness. Yeah.
I don't get it all.
Thank you for casting a good one.
But it's long fingernails are a bit of a trick.
Well, it makes you apply.
Yeah. No, other way around.
That's your fucking
hand. Oh, okay. Yeah, no, that makes more sense. I don't know.
There you
There's still swirlies in it.
Yeah, split it, break it up, and then knead it back together again.
Because they're both slightly different textures, but once you get them together, it's. Oh wow, yeah, this stuff's like silly putty.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, I'm trying to envision this as being food safe.
Right? Like.
Yeah. I guess once it sets, hopefully we'll get a different feel out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think that's done. Oh, just a little.